Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles. Today we are going to solve an ex-ante Vindoku Sudoku. This Sudoku was present in the Lockdown Sudoku contest that just concluded at Logic Masters India website. The contest is over, however you can still download the password protected booklet and enter the password and give the competition puzzles. I will add the link in the description to the contest page where you will have the password shown and you can enter the same in the password protected PDF and then you can solve the Sudokus at leisure. The Sudokus are excellent and they are worth giving a try. I will also add the online solving interface for this Sudoku in the description of the video. Please do have a try before watching this video. Now about the Sudoku, I got to know from the author himself, that is R. Kumaresan, that many of the top solvers had some difficulty while they attended this Sudoku. It may be because this is a relatively new variant and it has not occurred many times in the past. So the rules of the Sudoku are, in addition to standard classic Sudoku rules, each shaded 3x3 box, so you have 4 shaded 3x3 boxes, they are all called windows. So exactly 4 digits will appear twice and 1 digit which is called X will appear once in all the boxes. So in this window, you will have 4 different digits which will occur 2 times and 1 digit which will appear once. And similarly, you will have 4 different digits in this window which will appear 2 times and one digit which will occur once. However, the digit which is occurring once will be common across all 4 windows and it is called X. So that you have to determine. These are the rules. Now in the channel, we had earlier featured an ex-ante Vindoku Sudoku which was explained wonderfully by Ashish with all the techniques. However, for the benefit of our viewers who may be seeing this Sudoku for the first time or this video for the first time, I'll quickly run through the techniques. So trust me that after you watch these techniques, you will be able to solve ex-ante Vindoku, any ex-ante Vindoku, relatively faster and with much less effort. So to explain the technique, we'll move on to a different grid. So in any ex-ante Vindoku Sudoku, the green cells, the blue cells, the red cells, the yellow cells and the brown cells, right? In any ex-ante Vindoku Sudoku, the yellow cells, blue cells, green cells, red cells and brown cells will always contain the digits 1 to 9, right? So let us see now why this property applies. So we'll try to explain by taking some instances of digits. So you consider this window, you can take any window, you consider this window. Let us assume that there is a digit which is appearing 2 times in the window, right? We'll take that the digit to be A. The digit A is appearing 2 times in the window. Now we have these 3 rows, right? In any 3 rows or columns, you will have exactly 3 instances of a digit, right? Because there will be 3 sets of 1 to 9 and there will be exactly 3 instances of any digit in 3 rows. So we have got 2 instances of the digit in one window. The third instance of the digit cannot be in this window, right? Can you have? Because when you have the third instance of the digit here, then this digit becomes the X. But X has to appear exactly once in all the 4 windows as per rules. So you cannot have the third instance of the digit in this window, which means the third instance of this digit in the 3 rows must go into the green cells, right? So this is common for all digits. So you can have another digit which is B and B and which is occurring 2 times in this window. The third time this appears in these 3 rows must be in one of the green cells. So this is one of the techniques. So the next technique is, whichever digits which are appearing 2 times in this window cannot be present in this window and this window, that is the adjacent windows. Whichever digits which are present in these 2 windows, we just saw how why that is the case, because when you have 2 instances of the digit, the third instance cannot be present in the window because that becomes the X and third instance has to be present in the green cells. So similarly for these 2 windows, the same set of rule applies for the columns 2, 3 and 4. The third instance of the digit has to be present in the blue cell. So the second other trick is, whichever 4 digits occur 2 times in this window, those same 4 digits will also occur 2 times in these window, the diagonally opposite window. How is it the case? So we know that in a 9 by 9 grid, any digit will appear exactly 9 times, right? So we have got two times the digit, the third instance will go into the green cell, and the fourth instance along columns 3 and 4 will 2, 3 and 4 will go into the blue cell. And now we have 5 more instances of the grid, right? So if you look at columns 7, 8 and 9, you cannot have the digit A in this window anymore, right? We already proved that. Now, so in these cells, and these are orange, red cells you can say, you will have either the digit A 2 times or you will have 1 time, right? You cannot have 3 times, because if you have 3 times, then this window cannot have the digit A at all. You cannot have the digit A 3 times here. So, or the other way to look at it is, if you have a digit A 3 times here, then it is removing the instance of A from these blue cells. So you can have either 2 times or 1 time. So if you have 2 times in the yellow or red cells, then this means that the third instance of that will have to go into this window. And now we are violating the rule again, that there must be only one digit X which is appearing exactly once in all the 4 windows. So the moment you have a digit A here which is appearing once, and that is violating the rules, right? Because we have assumed A to be occurring 2 times already. So this means that one instance of the digit will go into the red cell, and two times the red, A would have to be present in this window, right? So this proves that whatever digit which appears 2 times in this window will also appear 2 times in this window. So you can try using any combination, A, B, C, D, you can try using B as well, and that digit will also be appearing 2 times in this window. So this is the next trick. The final trick is easy to see, right? So final trick is very easy. In any of the window, you will have exactly 5 different digits, right? 4 instances of digits which are appearing 2 times, and 1 digit which is appearing exactly 1. So you, in any window, you will have exactly 5 instances of digit, and though the 5 digits which is present in the top right and bottom left window are exactly same, and the 5 instances of digit which are present in top left and bottom right window are exactly same, as we just now proved, right? Now using these tricks, we will try to solve this Sudoku. This Sudoku was very tough. It was given a weightage of 100 points in the contest, and many of the top solvers had a difficulty solving this Sudoku. So we'll quickly highlight the cells. All the cells shaded in colors will also contain 1 to 9 as we just saw. Okay. So let us start the Sudoku now. So we know that the brown cells will also contain 1 to 9. Immediately I see that there are 3, 4, 7 and 9 given in the brown cells. So the remaining brown cells must contain 1, 2, 5, 6 and 8. This cell is quite constrained, right? 1, 2 and 5 are not possible. So this will be a 6 or 8, right? And you cannot have 2 in the first row. So 2 in the brown cell must go into either this cell or this cell, no other possibility. And using classic rules, for 1 you will have 1 either here or here. And in the green cells, if you look closely, you can't have a 9 here, you can't have a 9 here. So 9 must be present at least once, I mean exactly once in the green cell, and it cannot be here as well, so 9 would have to go here. And using classic rule, 9 must be present in one of these 2 cells. Right? So let us focus on the brown cells again. 3, 4, 7, 9, and 2 is also not possible. So 2 must be in one of these 2 cells. Remaining digits are 1, 5, 6 and 8, right? So this would be 1, 6 or 8. This must be 1, 5, 6 or 8, right? So let us look at the red cells now. We have 3 digits given already in red cells, 2, 5 and 6, right? So remaining digits are 6, remaining digits are 1, 3, 4, 7, 8 and 9. So looking at this cell, as it is quite constrained, it cannot be 3, 5, 8 and 9. Or a 1 or a 6. So this can only be 2, 4 or 7. but 2 is also not possible. So this is a 4 or a 7. So let us try to look at red cells which are quite constrained. So this cell was very constrained and it can have only 2 candidates. And let us look at these cells now. You can't have 2, 5, 6 in these cells. 4 or 7 is also not possible. So remaining possibilities are 1, 3, 8 and 9. So 1 and 9 is not possible here. So this will be 3 and 8. And this is going to be 1, 3, 8 and 9. Right? So let us look at the red cells in the top row now. So looking at this cell, as this is quite constrained, it cannot be 2, 7, 9, 3, 6 and 8. It can only be 1, 4 or 5. 4 is not possible. So this is 1 or a 5. And 5 is also not possible. So this means that this cell, because all the red cells need to contain 1 to 9, this must be 1 or 2. Now that is very helpful to us, because the moment we mark 1, 2 here, we can eliminate the 1 from here and from here, which means that in the brown cells, if you look closely, sorry, this will be a 5, 6 or 8. In the brown cells, if you look closely, we have a 6, 8 pair, right? So which means that this cell will be a 5. Beautiful. And now continuing in the classic way, because of this 5 and this 5, we get a 5 here, and that in turn gives a 5 here. And using classic rules, 5 must go into one of these two cells, right? Sorry, 5 must go into one of these two cells, but 5 cannot be in the purple cell, right? Because 5 is already here, so which means 5 would have to go here, and that pushes the 9 to this cell. And now using these two 5s, we get another 5 here, and the 5 in box 1 must go here, right? We have got all the 5s very easily. And let us look at the 9s now, because we just got a 9. So 9 in box 2 can't be here due to this 9, so we get a 9 here, and which means 9 must go into one of these two cells. And 9 in column 1 and column 2 give you a 9 here, using classic rule, because 9 cannot be here. And similarly, using classic rule again, 9 and 9 will give you 9 in one of these two cells, but 9 is not here, so this would be a 9, and that immediately gives a 9 here. So we are very able to progress really fast using this technique, right? That after shading all the cells, we are able to proceed very fast. So we have 3, 4, 7, 9, 6, 8, 5 in brown cells. Remaining digits are 1 and 2. They would have to go into these cells. We got a 1, 2 pair now. So this would have to be a 3 or 8, because 4, 5, 7, 6 and 9, 1 and 2 are already in place. So this will be a 3 or an 8. Let us look at column 8 now, because it is severely constrained. 1, 3, 8, 9, 5, 6 have been placed already. Remaining digits are 2, 4, 7. But 2 can't be here, 2 can't be here, so 2 would have to go here. This is a 2, which immediately gives a 1 here and a 2 here. So this must be either 4 or 7 for column 8, but 4 is here, so this would be a 7, this would be a 4. And now if you look closely along at the red cells, we have got 6 digits, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 and 9. Remaining digits are 3, 7, 8, but 7 cannot be here, 7 cannot be here, so 7 would have to go here. And which means this must be a 3 or 8. Now if you see, we have got 3, 7, 8, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 9, all the 9 digits in red cells. So remaining 2 digits are in column 6, 2, 1, 4, right? 1, 5, 7, 3, 6, 8, 9. So remaining digits are 2, 1, 4, but 4 is here. So this would have to be a 2 and this would have to be a 4. That's good. Now if you look closely at top right window, as we said earlier, any window can have exactly only 5 different digits. We have got already 4, 6, 9, 7 and 8. We can make a notation here. 4, 6, 9, 7 and 8 have been determined already, right? These are the 5 different digits in top right window, which means that in the bottom left window, we'll also have the same instances of digit. We cannot have any other different digit. So let us look at this box now. We can't have a 3 here, right? Because these are the only possible digits. So 3 must go. Sorry, 3 must go into this cell. And these two cells must be 6 and 8, but 6 can't be here. So this will be 8 and this will be 6. And now we have a triplet in this row, 1, 5, 6, 4, 8, 9. Remaining digits are 2, 3 and 7. So we can mark them 7 is here, 7 is here. So this would be a 7 and these two cells must be 2, 3. Let us look at box 6 now. 3, 4, 8, 5 and 9. 2, 1, 6 are not possible in these two cells. So we can make a 2, 6 pair. But if you look closely at the green cell, we already have a 2, right? So we can eliminate the 2 from here. So this would be a 6, this would be a 2. Very nice. So 3, 4, 6, 2, 5, 7 and 9, right? Remaining digits are 1 and 8 in the green cells. But 8 is here, so this will be a 1 and this will be an 8, which gives us 6 here. And in the brown cells, we need to have a 6, 8, that gives an 8 here. Wow. Because of this shading, guys, we are able to proceed very fast. I mean, in fact, we are able to proceed just like that on a hard Sudoku. So 1, 3, 8, 4, 5, 7, 9, remaining digits are 2 and 6. You have a 6 here, so this will be a 6, this will be a 2. And these two cells in row 3 must be 1 and 4. You have a 1 here, so this will be a 4, this will be a 1. And this must be a 4 now. And these two cells must be 3 and 8, right? To complete the box. And let us complete this box now. So 1 and 7 are the digits left. This is 1, so this will be 1 and this is 7. So in fact, using this technique, we are making this Sudoku look like child's play, but actually it is a very difficult Sudoku. So if you look at box 6, remaining digits are 3, 6. You have a 6 here, so this will be a 6, this will be a 3, and that gives an 8 here and a 3 here, and that gives an 8 here and a 3 here, and that gives a 2 here and a 3 here. And if you look at column 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 9 have been placed. Remaining digits are 4 and 8. We can place them. And now we need 1, 6 in this box. So 1 is here, so 1 has to go here. Sorry. 1 has to go here and 6 would have to go here. And this box needs to contain 2, 4, 8. 4 is here, so 4 would have to go here. And 2 and 8 are remaining digits, but 2 is here. So this will be an 8 and this will be a 2. And if you look at the column 4, the remaining left out digit is 7. And now we can be sure what is the digit which is the X digit, I mean, which is appearing exactly once. As you can see here in this box, 4 is the digit which is appearing exactly once. And there is no instance of any other digit which is appearing exactly once except 4. So 4 is the digit which is going to be the X digit. So column 5 can be filled now. This is 3. And these two cells can be filled now, which must be 7 and 8, right? For this column. So you have a 7 here. So this will be 8. This will be 7. And because of this, we get an 8 and a 4. And 2, 5, 7, 8, 1, 6, 9, we have a 4 here, so this will be a 4 and this will be a 3. So we have quickly completed the Sudoku using the powerful techniques that we covered in the video. Hope you guys were able to understand why these in different colored cells also contain 1 to 9. If you can quickly scan through the different colored cells, 4, 8, 9, 1, 2, 6, 3, 5, 7, 1, 4, 5, 3, 6, 9, 2, 7, 8, 3, 4, 6, 1, 2, 5, 7, 8, 9, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 6, 8, 9, and the brown cells also contain digits 1 to 9. And the second technique, that whichever 4 digits which appear 2 times here, namely 2, 3, 1 and 5, also appear 2 times here, if you see, namely 2, 3, 1 and 5. And similarly here, 4 is appearing once in exactly all the 4 windows, and 6 is appearing 2 times, 6 is appearing 2 times, 7, 8 and 9 are appearing 2 times, and 7, 8 and 9 are appearing 2 times. So this is the main techniques. These are the main techniques that you need to know when solving an X-anti-Vindoku Sudoku. And once you know them, solving any X-anti-Vindoku Sudoku becomes relatively easier. Hope you guys enjoyed watching me solve this brilliant Sudoku from the Lockdown Sudoku contest. Please let us know in comments if you would like us to solve any particular Sudoku or puzzle, and we would greatly appreciate if you support us by subscribing to the channel so that you do not miss any notifications from us. Hope to see you all soon. Thank you, guys.